Now, commodities on track for their worst month since March last year, but still on track for a fifth straight quarterly gain. Oil prices are steady as broad hopes for a demand recovery persisted. This was fueled by comments from the Secretary General of the Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries. He expects demand in 2021 to grow by 6 million barrels per day, with 5 million of that in the second half, slightly overshadowing travel curbs due to new outbreaks of the highly contagious Delta COVID-19 variant. Brent crude futures settling up 8 cents a barrel, while West Texas Intermediate settled up 7 cents a barrel after both retreating on Monday. Meanwhile, gold also falling to its lowest level since April, ending 1% lower to $1,763 an ounce. It even tumbled by as much as 1.7%, dragged by a pickup in yields for government debt and firmness in the U.S. dollar. Elon Musk's satellite internet network, Starlink, now has nearly 70,000 active users. The Tesla CEO and SpaceX founder says he's ready to invest as much as $30 billion into Starlink as he aims for near global coverage of the world this year. Starlink is an array of low orbit satellites offering high speed connectivity for people living in remote areas. It currently has over 1,500 satellites aloft and is operating in about a dozen countries. But skeptics question whether satellite internet can ever develop a viable business model, as its target market is just too few in number to support the vast upfront investment costs.
The combined power of all the satellites is over 5 megawatts. They're capable of outputting about 30 terabits per second of data. And starting in next month, starting in August, we should have global connectivity for everywhere except the poles. Now, as I said, it's really meant for sparsely populated regions. So our spot size, talking in terms of cellular, is quite big. So we're well suited to low to medium density areas, but not to high density areas.
The Nasdaq and the S&P 500 notching yet another record highs, boosted by an upbeat U.S. consumer confidence report. The S&P 500 ticked up to 4291 for its fourth straight record close, helped by a jump in Morgan Stanley shares on news of a dividend increase. The tech-heavy Nasdaq also booking another record, lifted by Apple and other tech stocks. The Dow, though, as you can see, closing unchanged, little change that is. The U.S. consumer confidence index jumping to 127.3 points in June. That is the highest level in 16 months, as growing labor market optimism amid a reopening economy offset concerns about elevated inflation. This sets a positive tone for the June jobs report coming out this Friday. Meanwhile, home builder stocks moved higher after S&P case Schiller said home prices rose more than 14% in April compared to the prior year. Now, another report showed the Federal Housing Finance Agency House Price Index also shooting up to a record 15.7% in April, after rising 14% in March. But economists do not believe another housing bubble is developing, as the surge is being mostly driven by a mismatch between supply and demand rather than poor lending practices, which triggered the 2008 global financial crisis.
I don't think we're headed for a correction, but I do think we're heading for some sort of a pullback, because there is a little bit too much complacency in the market right now. But you know, you really can't help but saying the reasons are for the right reasons. And if you look at today's macro indicators, we had very strong housing data. And what really impressed me was the huge jump that we got in consumers' confidence. We were up 7 points from last month to 127. And again, that tells me that consumer spending is going to get very strong over the next 4 to 5 months. So we're headed for a very strong second half.
Taking a look now at U.S. stock futures, all major indices pointing to a higher open when trading resumes tonight, Manila time. Now, over here in Asia, markets are rising in early trade as investors await China's manufacturing activity data. Australia's benchmark ASX 200 also up nearly 1% as authorities there ramp up vaccination efforts to stem a fresh COVID-19 outbreak. Japan's Nikkei 225 adding 0.4%, despite data showing that the country's industrial output posted the biggest monthly drop in the year in May, down 5.9% due to a sharp fall in car production. The estimate was just for a 2% contraction there. Meanwhile, South Korea's KOSPI index also up nearly 0.5% as the country's industrial output jumped 15.6% in May. While it did jump, it is still below expectations of about 18% growth from consensus. And moving on, of course, that is due to the auto chip shortages for South Korea failing to hit consensus. Now, commodities on track for their worst month since March last year, but still on track for a fifth straight quarterly gain. Oil prices are steady as broad hopes for a demand recovery persisted. This was fueled by comments from the Secretary General of the Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries. He expects demand in 2021 to grow by 6 million barrels per day, with 5 million of that in the second half, slightly overshadowing travel curbs due to new outbreaks of the highly contagious Delta COVID-19 variant. Brent crude futures settling up 8 cents a barrel, while West Texas Intermediate settled up 7 cents a barrel after both retreating on Monday. Meanwhile, gold also falling to its lowest level since April, ending 1% lower to $1,763 an ounce. It even tumbled by as much as 1.7%, dragged by a pickup in yields for government debt and firmness in the U.S. dollar. The Philippine Central Bank sees June inflation settling at 4.3%. Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno says higher prices of domestic petroleum products, along with higher power rates and a slightly weaker peso, are the main sources of upward price pressures. But he notes these could be partially offset by the decline in prices of key food items. Philippine inflation stood at 4.5% for a third straight month in May. The country's June inflation report is due to come out next week.